Hello everyone, this is Ashish Jain. This is a continuation video on procedure of dividend and payment of dividend. In this video, we will discuss about series of event. Series of event here means we will discuss procedure and payments of dividend. I have already drafted a table. From this table you can memorize all the days that what is the declaration of dividend, what is the last date of declaration of dividend, how will company will pay this dividend. Okay, now the first event of dividend is that the company need to declare dividend. So after declaration dividend, that company need to deposit that the amount of dividend in schedule bank in a separate bank account within 5 days from the date of declaration. I repeat, after the declaration of dividend, every company need to deposit the amount of declaration of dividend in schedule bank in a separate bank within 5 days from the date of dividend. Okay, and in case company fails to do so, which means if the company failed to declare dividend within 5 days, then the company liable to pay interest at the rate of 18% per annum. Okay, now the question is, every company will have to pay this interest? No, this interest is not applicable to government company, which means if any company acquire the entire paid up share capital by the central government as or by state government, that is called government company, and this interest is not applicable to government company. Why? Because this whole amount of interest will automatically go to government. Now why government pay to itself? So this rule is not applicable to government. Now the next procedure is, after depositing in schedule bank, that the company now need to pay dividend. When within 30 days from the date of declaration. All of you please see this table. The company need to make payment to dividend within 30 days from the date of declaration. Okay. Now the next step is, if the company fail to make payment to dividend, for example, let's take an example. Suppose company declare 5% dividend, and suppose there are around 1 lakh shareholders who hold the share of that company. Now the question is, suppose if the company paid only 3% dividend to these shareholders, or company paid this 5% amount of share of dividend to only 70,000 shareholders, again this is called unpaid dividend. So what we do about this unpaid dividend? So the amount of unpaid dividend transfer to unpaid dividend account within 7 days from the date of payment of dividend. I repeat, if the company failed to make payment to shareholders for the amount of dividend, then the company need to transfer such amount to unpaid dividend account within 7 days from the date of payment of dividend. Okay, and again, if the company failed to do so, or in case of default in transferring, then the company liable to pay interest at the rate of 12% per annum. Now, what will happen to this amount? That now the company need to mention the valid reason why company failed to do so. Okay, why such company didn't make payment to this dividend. So which means if the company, if the shareholders not claim the amount of dividend, then the company need to prepare report and give valid reasons. Then to whom they share the to whom, or you can say who are the shareholders that they are not claim that they have not claimed the dividend. Then the company need to mention all the details about the shareholders, that is name, address, and place, and put up all these details in the official website. When within 90 days from the transfer of unpaid dividend account. I repeat, if the company fail to transfer such amount of dividend to the unpaid dividend account within the stipulated time period, then company need to pay interest at the rate of 12% per annum. And then that company need to mention in their official website and give the valid reason why the company failed to do so and who are the shareholders. And then they need to mention all the details about the shareholders, that is name, address, and place. And all these details need to put up on official website within 90 days from the date of such transfer. Now you will see what will happen to this amount, whether this amount will remain in this account. Actually, the thing is government giving some benefit here to the company, that, or you can say company giving government giving a huge time to the company to pay such amount of dividend to all the shareholders. Then government will ask that the if this amount remain unpaid for 7 years in unpaid dividend account, then this whole amount will transfer to Investor Education and Protection Fund, and this fund which is to be regulated by government. We will talk about this fund later on detail mein padhenge acche se. Okay, so this is the all about the series of event, or you can say timeline of dividend. So I hope you have understood this very well. You will This chart will definitely help you to memorize all these things. Now let's take up another topic, that is types of dividend. Yes, the next topic is types of dividend. There are basically two types of dividend, as we already discussed in the last video, that is final dividend and interim dividend. Now what is final dividend and what is interim dividend? The final dividend is, it is a dividend which is declared at the annual general meeting of a company. Annual general meeting means which is to be held by the company once in a year. And interim dividend means it is a dividend which is to be declared between two annual general meeting of a company. Suppose if the company's annual general meeting held on Feb in 2018, now the next AGM to be held on, suppose, on Jan 2018. Now in between these two AGM, the company need to declare interim dividend if they want. If this is not compulsory, this is not mandatory to declare interim dividend. Okay, and it is to be declared in board meeting, not in AGM, but is to be declared between two AGMs. Now, what are the sources? Which means from where the company will pay such amount of dividend. Okay. In case of the final dividend, if the company have sufficient amount of reserve or accumulated amount of profit from in the last year, and they will calculate the profit of the current year also, so they will declare accordingly the final dividend. So it is to be declared out of current as well as current year profit. Now, whereas in interim dividend, it is to be declared only out of profit of the quarters. Now the question is, why company is basically go for interim dividend? Because they have already option for final dividend, then why company go for interim dividend? The situation is when the company have that the company is basically outperforming. Basically, company that the board of directors basically project इन एडवांस, लाइक कि हाउ मच अमाउंट ऑफ प्रॉफिट दे आर गोइंग टू अर्न इन दिस ईयर और इन दिस क्वार्टर, एंड वट एवर अमाउंट ऑफ प्रॉफिट दे हैव ऑलरेडी अर्न इन इन दैट पर्टिकुलर क्वार्टर, दे विल डिक्लेयर इंटरिम डिविडेंड. बेसिकली दे वॉन्ट टू टेल गिव अ मैसेज टू दिस ऑल द शेयर होल्डर्स दैट द कंपनी इज गोइंग टू आउट परफॉर्म इन द फ्यूचर. ओके, नाउ वट इज द रेट ऑफ डिविडेंड? इन द केस ऑफ फाइनल डिविडेंड द रेट ऑफ डिविडेंड इज ऑब्वियसली मोर देन द रेट ऑफ इंटरिम डिविडेंड, एंड इन द केस ऑफ इंटरिम डिविडेंड इट इज ऑब्वियसली लेस देन द फाइनल डिविडेंड. नाउ वट आर द लीगल आस्पेक्ट्स? डायरेक्टर्स ऑफ फाइनल डिविडेंड इज ऑलवेज लीगल बिकॉज इट इज डिक्लेयर्ड ओनली आफ्टर फाइंडिंग करेक्ट प्रॉफिट्स. एज आई टोल्ड यू दैट द फाइनल डिविडेंड इज टू बी डिक्लेयर आफ्टर कैलकुलेटिंग ऑल द प्रॉफिट ऑफ द करंट ईयर एज वेल एज द प्रीवियस ईयर, एंड द डायरेक्टर विल बी फाइंडिंग आउट ऑल दिस प्रॉफिट्स एंड देन डिक्लेयर ऑल द एंड देन डिक्लेयर फाइनल डिविडेंड. सो दिस इज द लीगल प्रोसीजर. Whereas in the case of interim dividend, directors will held personally liable to fund to refund the amount of interim dividend if the company incur a loss at the end of this year, at the end of year. Now, as I told you that the if the director feel too free, or you can say if they think fit to declare the interim dividend because they feel that their company will definitely perform well in this year, so that's why they are going for interim dividend. But if the in the case of inverse situation, that means if the company do not perform well, or the of if they if the company incur any loss, then the amount of loss of the company will be held personal level by directors only. Now authorization means that the in the case of final dividend, the company it is not mandatory to mention about the final dividend in the articles of association. Authorization of articles is not necessary to declare it to declaration for the declaration of final dividend. Articles of association means it is a written document where the company need to mention about all objectives, what will they be, what they are going to do in this year or in the next year. So they need to mention about all this in articles of association. So the point here is, in the case of final dividend, the company is not mandatory to mention about this final dividend, but in the case of interim dividend they need to mention. It is necessary, or you can say it is mandatory to mention about this, or mention about interim dividend. Now the question is, who will declare these dividend? Final dividend to be decided by board of directors, but it is declared by shareholders at AGM. Whereas in the case of interim dividend, it is to be declared by board of directors by passing special resolution at board meeting. I repeat, it is to be declared in board meeting by passing special resolution. Okay. So this is the whole concept about the types of dividend, that is interim dividend and final dividend. I hope you understood this all this concept, and if you have any query, we will discuss in the live class. Thank you.